3-on-3 as Philip Broberg gets back. And here's a break and a score by McDavid. .49 for the league leader.
Talk about McDavid. We touched on it in the open. You know, how do you defend this guy? It's just so difficult. You can see the recovery try right there by Charlie McAvoy. He does a decent job to get back and try to take the angle.
Nurse around for Vincent Dernay. Oh, Nosek scores! 13 seconds, the answer! What we told you, no lead is safe. That one just lasted 13 seconds.
Right back with your fourth line. Try to establish a little bit of offensive zone. What a touch pass right there by Garnet Hathaway deep in the offensive zone. Orlov pitches all the way down. He throws a puck to the forehand side of the right-handed shooting Hathaway, who chops down.
The effort against Kaylor Yamamoto. McDavid tries to feed Yamamoto in a seam. 2-on-1. Coyle to Foligno. He scores! A lead change in the first 15 minutes and change of this game.
It's onside. You know, criticized the Bruins the last time McDavid was on the ice for turnover, as well as McDavid's going to turn the puck over here, which leads to numbers for Boston. And it's Foligno and Coyle that execute well on the 2-on-1, and great finish by Foligno. I mean, both passes, the pass by Foligno at the blue line to make sure you get it to the man that's open and give him the options. That's Charlie Coyle. Also have different names because it saves a lot of time in your prep to practice. And you pay attention, Jack, and you study the game, and you know the game, and, you know, chances are you are going to move. Not a lot of guys play for that same team forever, right?
CeCe rolls it the length of the rink. A centering pass, and 50 for McDavid.
In a position where Swayman can't come out and play the puck, and the aggressive line change by the Edmonton Oilers, because it's the second period, they're going to have the advantage of being further up the ice. The Oilers don't have possession, so it's not going to be a too many men on the ice when that line change is occurring, but it's the advantage for McDavid to come all alone. The Bruins can't get back in time. It's just, it's like a mini breakaway.
Blocked by Kulak. Clifton pries it loose to Orlov. Swayman makes a good save on Puljujarvi.
That forward shot hit the crossbar.
I heard something tink. Pastrnak in the final minute. Knocked down and such a goal by Zacha! Pavel Zacha!
Shifts with good offensive zone time. The Forsberg crossbar again, possession, five-man rotation, put the puck to the net. You can see Skinner trying to extend that goaltending stick to knock it out of danger, but it's that second effort by Zacha right there to dive out.
Swayman paddles to Carlo. It deflects, and Yamamoto was set up by Nugent Hopkins. McDavid to Yamamoto, and Swayman holds his line. The Bruins under pressure right away in the third. Shakes his hand after the block. DeBrusque to Pastrnak. Marchand, a save by Skinner. A diving save. Pastrnak blocked. Dreisaitl with five, and the Bruins go to 3-0. On the Western swing, they beat Edmonton 3-2.